Are you a SwiftUI developer wanting to try out all the goodies that iOS 17 brings? Maybe you want to take a look at Vision OS? If you answered yes to that, then stop right here. Today is the day when you are going to download Xcode 15 beta. And if you don't know how to do that, you're in luck, because in this video, I'm going to show you step by step how to download and install Xcode 15 beta. Let's get into it. Xcode 15 beta is amazing, and if you want to learn more about the new features, go ahead and check out store.rebeloper.com/community, where on the weekly events I dissect Xcode 15. Go ahead and check it out. Now, today we are going to learn how to download and install Xcode 15 beta. Go to developer.apple.com and scroll all the way down till you see the downloads link. Click on the download resources. Of course, you have to sign in to your developer account. And let's just wait for that. And select applications. And then view downloads. Okay, we want to go to Xcode 15 beta, or the latest one that you see right over here, because new betas will arrive soon. Click on view details, and you will see that we can also select the platforms that we would like to develop for. Now, first you want to download the iOS 17 beta, and then the Xcode 15 beta archive. So make sure that this is checked. Of course, you can select watchOS and tvOS if you wish to, but I'm just going to select iOS 17 beta only. So click on that, and let's just wait for it to download. Become a SwiftUI master and join the vibrant community of SwiftUI Nation. Attend our weekly Zoom events to stay up to date with the latest SwiftUI advancements. Learn insider tips and connect with fellow developers. Don't miss out on this incredible opportunity to level up your SwiftUI skills. Join us now at store.rebeloper.com/community. Okay, it looks like it's completing the download. As you can see, we downloaded first the manifest and then the simulator runtime DMG. Okay, so make sure that you leave this in your downloads folder. It will be used when we are going to open up Xcode beta for the first time. Okay, so now what you want to do is uncheck iOS 17 beta and click on the link again. Now, this will start to download Xcode beta. As you can see, we have another manifest right over here, and it's downloading Xcode 15 and beta, the zip file. So let's just wait for this to download also. Okay, next up, what you want to do is open up the Xcode 15 beta. So double click on it, and the archive utility will expand it. Let's just wait for this. This shouldn't take that much. Okay, it looks like it's almost done extracting it. And what you can do right now is just move the extracted Xcode beta into your applications folder. So let's just do that. Just drag and drop it right over there. Okay, so now just go under applications and scroll all the way down, and you can see Xcode is living side by side my Xcode beta. What you want to do is just double click on it and open it up for the very first time, and that will trigger the runtime DMG to be installed. So again, let's just wait for this. Here we go. And now what you want to do is let's just create a new project. And let me resize that. And as you can see, iOS 17 not installed. Let's just get that. And it will just download it and install it for you. Of course, if you haven't downloaded it already, as we already did, this will just extract iOS 17 simulator for you. Let's just wait for this too. Okay, it's finishing up 100%, and now it is installing. Let's just see how much that will take, and with the power of editing, we are going to jump right to the end of that. And yeah, we don't even need editing. We can close this, And let's click on. And by the way, if you just go to watchOS or macOS, sorry, tvOS and watchOS, you can get all of the others. And then let's click on next right over here. Let's just go for our first app. And yeah, there is also Swift Data, which I will cover on the YouTube channel. So go ahead and hit that subscribe button if you already haven't done so. Let's click on next right over here. Drop it somewhere that you like. Let's just go under documents. Let's create that. And if you want to add more simulators, as you saw, we can do that when we are creating a brand new project, or go to Xcode and settings. Let me just drag it right over here. Select platforms, and there you will find the necessary platforms that you might want to add in there. So that is how easy it is to download and install Xcode 15 beta onto your computer. Now, if you'd like to know how to master data handling in SwiftUI, go ahead and check out the video. It's right over here.